Well, as I said, these elections that are coming up quite soon, these are elections for the Scottish Parliament. These are important elections. Important because after 8 years, the Parliament has to some extent bedded down, and it's time now to consider what should happen next. I do not believe in independence for Scotland. I said that when I came here in 1959, God help me. I still believe it is the wrong course of action. Of course I believe that Scotland should have the maximum influence over its own domestic affairs. Of course I believe that we should strengthen the Parliament and give it more powers. But I'm in no doubt whatsoever that the best place for Scotland is as a powerful part, constituent part, of the United Kingdom. Exercising influence, being responsible for our own legal system, being responsible for our health and our education, yes, and being responsible for the environment. Because we know that if the problems of climate change are going to be properly dealt with, they have to be dealt with at a local level as much as at a national level. The really interesting thing about the United States, I can just revert to that for a moment, is that while President George W. Bush denies climate change, out in California, Arnold Schwarzenegger, the rather improbable governor of that rather improbable state, has actually started to put into place restrictions which are as good as, if not better, than those necessary to achieve the targets in the Kyoto Agreement. We're going to deal with the issue of climate change. We have to deal with it locally. We have to deal with it individually. Our own personal lifestyles have got to change. We can all make a contribution. But these are the issues which concern people in this country, health and education and the environment. They're concerned about the sort of health provision there will be for them and for their families. Concerned about education. Concerned, quite rightly, as I'm sure you are, about higher education. They're concerned to ensure that we maintain the particular Scottish advantage of not charging tuition fees, something which was a Liberal Democrat policy, and something of which we are proud that the executive has adopted. And so to embark upon a referendum about independence would, in my judgment, be an enormous distraction from the importance of these issues. We've had constitutional change. Constitutional change is best achieved when it's done in a calm and a rational way. And it's not done off the back of arguments of which have the effect dividing a nation rather than drawing it together. So I'm against independence. I make no apology for that. I always have been, and I doubt I shall change my mind. And that's why I'm against a referendum. That's why Nicol Stephen, who leads the Liberal Democrats, has made it clear we will not have any truck with any party that wants to have a referendum. Because the constitutional issue is not the issue which drives the interests and the anxieties of people in this country. You know that 6 out of 10 children in Glasgow live in poverty. I didn't know that until recently, until I was preparing for a speech I made last week in Aviemore. In this country, the richest 1/5 pay a lower proportion of their income in tax than the poorest 1/5. During the lifetime of this government, the last 10 years of this government, the gap between rich and poor has widened rather than narrowed. Who would have believed that of a Labour government? We know, for example, that in England in 1997 there were a million families looking for social on the lists for social housing. The figure today is 1.6 million. So poverty is being engendered. Poverty is accelerating in some parts of our society. Now, isn't that something we should be concentrating upon, rather than upon a referendum for independence or something of that kind? Isn't that something that should be a sense of shame to every one of us, all of us in this room, that with the good fortune to either have had higher education or the opportunity of higher education, we have to go very far out of here to find places where that poverty is obvious, stares you in the face? I think that's a mission, if you like, for people like ourselves who've had the good fortune to be given the opportunities which we have. Now, these are the things which drive my politics. And I believe these are the things which should drive politics, not only at Westminster, but at Holyrood as well. this is a great university, founded in 1451. It's a place of enormous learning, a place, as I've said already, of opportunity, a place in which I hope you feel the same sense of pride as I do when I come back. I'm slightly overtaken by nostalgia. Too many nights in the beer bar with old friends, I suspect. Too much of that, too many late nights at debates. All of that comes flooding back. I'm enormously proud of this place and of my connection with this place. I hope you are too. But I would like you to be enormously proud of the political system in this country. And I would like you to be enormously proud of the people who are part of it.